Welcome to the session 3. Session 3 is Phases and Different Structures of Vermi Composting. The main objective of this session is we are going to see the different stages of Vermi Composting and what are the structures we are going to employ for this Vermi Composting process. In this session, we are going to cover 3 main subheadings: general outline, phases of Vermi Composting, and structures for Vermi Compost production. We'll move on to the general outline. So general outline includes 6 main topics. First one is collection of waste, the second segregation of waste, the third pre-digestion, vermicomposting, finished product and its enrichment, then the quality control and marketing. Now move on to the second topic of this session, phases of vermicomposting. There are 5 important phases in the case of vermicomposting process. The first one is the collection and mechanical separation or segregation and then shredding. The second process is pre-digestion. In the case of vermicomposting process, we should give the pre-digestion period of 3 weeks. Here, before going for pre-digestion, we have to collect the material. We are shredded now. Yes, it is ready. Now, we have to mix the cow dung. The cow dung should not be fresh, it should be dried. So you mix the cow dung, allow for the pre-digestion period of 20 or 22 days, and then we can go in for composting process as such. Then the third phase is how to select, that is how to prepare a bed. Okay, pre-digested material is ready. Where to put this pre-digested material? What type of the structures I need? It depends upon the convenience and the economics and actual economical background of anyone. And then the fifth step is, after separating this worms and the matured compost, we have to store it properly for our use. Next, we move on to the third topic, structures of vermicompost production. You can see the picture. There are 4 different types, isn't it? This one thing is tank, the other is heap, the third is silpolling bag, the fourth is pit.